Live on FS1 from Madison Square Garden, it started with over 2,800 dogs, over 200 breeds from 49 states and 16 countries, down to 7 group winners. Only one will be named the best in show.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the 7 group winners competing for best in show at the 141st Westminster Dog Show. The winner of the herding group, German Shepherd Dog, number 22.
Round of applause for Rumor.
The winner of the sporting group, Irish Setter, number 14.
Here comes Adrian, Irish Setter.
An Irish Setter has never won.
That's right.
Best in show.
Adam Bernadin is handling. He's won the group before with Irish Setters, but an Irish Setter, as you said, has not won best in show in Westminster.
The winner of the working group, Boxer, number 19.
Here comes Devlin with Diego Garcia.
Not since 1970 has a boxer won best in show.
Devlin hails from Canada. She won second place in the working group last year, and this year she's tackled the first place.
The winner of the hound group, Norwegian Elkhound, number 7.
Here comes Duffy, Pat Trotter. As we mentioned last night, Pat Trotter has won the hound group 11 times with Norwegian Elkhound. Last night was her 11th win. A Norwegian Elkhound is not won a best in show before. So yep. This could be it. This could be her year.
A few surprises here on the final 7.
The winner of the non-sporting group, Miniature Poodle, number 49.
Comes Afton, owned by Daniel Chavez, Jimmy and Janet Moses. Jimmy Moses, of course, is famous for his best in show win at Westminster with Manhattan. Now he has Afton in the ring. Daniel is the handler tonight.
The winner of the Terrier group, Norwich Terrier, number 7.
This is Tanner with Susan Depew. Norwich Terrier has not won best in show since 1998. Tanner, best in show at Montgomery Kennel Club. Montgomery County. I'll see how he does tonight. So far, so good. Group 1 in the Terrier group.
The winner of the toy group, Pekingese, number 16.
This is Chucky being breeder owner handled, or carried in for right now, by David Fitzpatrick.
Now, why carry him?
Well, I think he's just trying to get him to where the judge is now going to be able to see him.
That's Chucky.
Chucky is the son of Malachi, who won best in show in 2012. And David was also the breeder owner and handler.
Favorable bloodlines here, but we know whoever gets best in show will be a first-time best in show winner. Thomas J. Bradley III, Watertown, New York, who spoke about being sequestered and now having to make the major decision.
He's very excited about it, I'm sure. Mr. Bradley is a very well-respected dog person. Comes from sporting breeds. He currently has Border Terriers at home. He was the show chairman for the Westminster Kennel Club for 15 years. And now has the pleasure of judging best in show.
Congratulations, Pat.
He's going to take a first look. He's walking down the line. General impressions.
Nice job, Susie. Congratulations.
Congratulating each of the handlers.
Congratulations, David.
You heard him talking to the handlers, congratulating them. Mr. Bradley's been in the dog sport for so long, he knows a lot of people.
Originally bred as a sheep herding and protection dog in Germany, it is competitive in herding, obedience, agility, tracking, and successful both as a service dog and a policeman's best friend and protector. This is German Shepherd Dog, number 22.
Champion Lockenhaus, rumor has it, the Kenley. Rumors owned by D. Stearns, P. Buckles,
and
P. Dickman.
As slowly as is comfortable for the two of you.
Okay.
And when you come back, you stop and then go around at your own speed. Thank you.
And the herding group, the winner of the herding group has only won one best in show.
In 1987, and it was a German Shepherd named Hatter. Kent Boyles handling the dog from Maumee, Ohio. Kent's working to get the dog's expression, get the ears up.
Okay, sir, right around. Thank you.
Rumor from Herding Group 2016 and 2017, Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show.
The Irish Setter has been called the most beautiful of dogs with a rich red flowing coat. His regal bearing turns heads wherever he goes. A rollicking personality is a trademark of the breed. At home, he is loyal and loving companion. In the field, a swift moving hunter pointing to upland birds. This is Irish Setter, number 14.
Champion Vermilion Seabreeze, Adrian.
Oh, he's got the bait in his pocket.
Straight down and back, not too fast. Then go around at your own speed the second time. Again, a minute.
Adrian is owned by Sandra Nordstrom, Bruce and Mary Foote. As we said before, an Irish Setter is yet to win Best in Show at Westminster. Very nice. Dog is setting itself up, as Rumor the Shepherd did. Mr. Bradley's giving them a few more moments to let the dog free stack and set themselves up and show themselves off.
The boxer is fearless, highly intelligent, and happy. Originally bred to run down and hold wild boar and bear, is not a dog for the timid and can be protective when called upon. Extremely intuitive, he is at all times responsive to his owner's moods and is a fine alert companion for any family. This is boxer number 19.
Champion Mephisto, speak of the devil. Devlin?
Okay, let's take him straight down and back fairly slowly and go around at your own rate when you come back.
Devlin is handled by Diego Garcia, owned by Mrs. Jack Bilhart and Sergio Tenenbaum.
Working with that treat.
Well, he's going to keep the dog's attention. Devlin won the group second last year. Diego's taking his time, making sure that every foot is placed properly.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Crowd at Madison Square Garden, rooting for all the dogs equally. This is it. These top seven dogs have made it to the pinnacle of our sport, best in show ring.
And the other competitors waiting patiently for their turn.
As a loyal companion of the Vikings, the Norwegian Elkhound was originally used to hunt moose and other big game, which it still does today in its native Norway. This hardy hunter did double duty as a guard dog for campsites and a herder of flocks. They were first imported to America at the turn of the 20th century. This is Norwegian Elkhound, number 7.
Champion Vilmelka's Daggerwood Delight. This is Duffy.
Let's go straight down and back, nice and easy to right. Yes. And then the second time you can pick it up a little
bit. Come on now, nice and easy, easy.
Owner handled by Pat Trotter, Carmel, California. You heard Mr. Bradley giving instruction. Take it nice and easy. That's so that he can judge the dog properly. Watch the dog skate.
Okay, right around, thank you.
At a nice easy pace. And now she can speed it up a little, he noted.
So a dog can enhance their chances at this moment in the eyes of the judge.
The poodle is an old hunting dog of unknown origin. Germany and France both had their poodles, but it was the French who made it their national dog. Poodles come in three varieties based on size, but they are all one breed. The miniature shown here must be under 15 inches, but in excess of 10. This is miniature poodle number 49.
Thank you. Let's take her down fairly slowly and then bring her back the same way. And then when you go around, use your own pace. Thank you.
This is champion Dan for Avalon As If, Afton. It's being handled by Daniel Chavez. It's owner and also owned by James and Janet Moses. To answer your question, the dogs at this point in the show, every foot has to be right. The performance has to be flawless. So it's the handler's responsibility to make that happen.
No missteps.
No missteps.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
There goes Afton from Wentzville, Missouri.
The Norwich Terrier has been a breed in this country since 1936. Spirited, stocky, with sensitive prick ears and a slightly foxy expression, he is one of the smallest working terriers. Don't let the small size fool you. The Norwich is an energetic breed, requiring a large daily dose of fun and frolic. This is Norwich Terrier, number 7.
Champion Taylorson, twice as nice.
Thank you. Fairly slowly going back down and back, and then pick it up.
Tanner's owned by Lisa Sons, being handled by Susan Depew.
Tanner from Homer Glen, Illinois, 4.5 years old.
Tanner had a big win October at the winning best in show at Montgomery County. And we'll see if tonight's another big night. What already is, he won the Terrier.
That's right, already in the big show. One more after this for further inspection.
Got it, right around, thank you.
Judge Thomas Bradley.
Been one of the most popular of all toy breeds. His tapering hindquarters, massive front end, and mane earn him the name Lion Dog. The standard calls for an unhurried, dignified, and rolling gait, as you see here. He dates from the 8th century in China, where he was considered sacred. This is Pekingese, number 16.
Champion Pequest Pickwick. Chucky is breeder owner handled.
To do that. Thank you very much.
The handler, David Fitzpatrick, breeder owner handler, lifting the dog. Shows his
obviously part way is fine.
Show his expression, headpiece. Now David's taking Chucky down and back. Mr. Bradley said about halfway. Oh, Chucky knows that's far enough.
Chucky was carried out partially to start this.
It's a young dog.
Thank you, sir.
Could be a winner in there somewhere.
Chucky's father won best in show 2012. Malachi. See if he can follow in his father's footsteps. Mr. Bradley's going to now see, come take another look, maybe at expression. You might have them go around again. Crowd is excited. I'm sure the handlers are excited, but trying to remain calm. Obviously, the moment is very exciting, but you have to maintain your calm, cool demeanor. Your emotions as a handler travels right down the lead to the dog. So you have to make sure that your performance as a handler is perfect so that your dog's performance is perfect.
Good girl.
Tremendous composure by all of these group winners.
They're very experienced show dogs. But the garden is different. When you're at Madison Square Garden with this many people cheering for you, it's a little different atmosphere than a regular dog show.
It's the biggest stage. Talk about most of these have been in over 100 dog shows. A lot of blood, sweat, and fears to get here.
Everybody up, please. One at a time, Adam. Right around and come right back to me, please, sir.
I'm sorry, what?
Once around, come right back here.
Okay.
Ball alone.
Ready?
Yep.
There goes Rumor, one time around. Winner of the herding group, second time.
Sir.
Perfect stack.
It's quite a variety from the size to the colors and the personalities.
That's right, but as a judge at this level, Mr. Bradley knows the standards. He's studied them. Very experienced judge. He's judging each dog as a reminder against their own written standard.
Now the boxer. Devlin goes, are the dogs, I'm sure, like the handlers and those in attendance, anxious. Let's go. Let's name a winner.
Well, they're excited, too. I mean, but they generally feed off the crowd. They love the crowd. They love the noise and the attention. They generally have their best night at the Garden. That's what the handlers have told us in the past. Devlin there, striking a pose. She hasn't put a foot wrong. None of them have.
Need to be at your best to be the best in show.
At this point, Mr. Bradley is making sure that each dog has a good look. He's giving them equal opportunity, equal time. Make sure he sees everything that he needs to see about these dogs. He's watching them free bait here, free stack.
Thank you, man.
I'm sure he's having a good time judging, but also it's a lot of, there's a lot of pressure here. These are a lot, all of them are beautiful examples of their breeds. Comes down to who tonight is really asking for it.
By asking for it?
By asking for it, there's just something there. It's a special something. So far, every dog
has seemed to,
it's been perfect. So.
Has shown up. I mean, that's why he's taking so long. They've all been so good. Crowd trying to influence.
That happens in New York City. You have the crowd influence in this arena oftentimes. Doesn't faze the judges, though. When now when you're judging dogs, you're in your zone and you're watching the gate, make sure that it's appropriate for their breed, headpiece. Coat texture, he's already gone over every dog, and now he's just taking one more good look.
...140 previous years. Which of these will be next for best in show?
It's important to remember we're going to be doing reserve best in show awarding first, which is like a runner-up position. That means they're the dog that was closest to also winning best in show. We'll be doing that awarding first and then best in show. Mr. Bradley's taking it all in again. Dogs are, haven't moved a foot. They're not letting the crowd affect their performance either.
Look at Rumor, Focus, the German Shepherd.
Okay. Mr. Bradley's going to the table now. Going to sign his judge's book. That means he's made his decision.
Tough decision.
Very tough decision.
And he worked it over. He thought of long time, long and hard.
Okay.
The handlers are regrouping, reset the dogs up. They know a decision's already been made. I just don't know which dog.
A lot of time and love and money put into this. No cash prizes for the preservation of the breed, pride, and bragging rights.
There's a lot of work behind all of the responsible breeders that have produced these beautiful animals.
Start 11, 15.
Okay. All right.
Dedicated to producing the next generation of healthful, purebred dogs.
Good job, man.
If you're interested in getting a dog, you should reach out and find a breeder of merit.
Reserve first. Is this reserve?
Hopefully watching tonight. Got a good sense.
We gotta get rid of the glasses now.
Of what it's all about.
Here we go.
As many of you know, I've stood here in this spot for the last 16 years, but I've been holding the trophy, not the ribbon, and this makes a big difference. I'm very grateful to Mr. McCarthy and Mr. Helming and the members of Westminster Kennel Club. It's a great honor. For Reserve Best in Show tonight, may I have the Irish Setter, please?
Yeah!
Thank you. Adrian, the Irish Setter, the
Reserve
runner.
Reserve Best in Show. For the Irish Setter, it's incredible. Adam Bernadin with Adrian. Mr. Bradley's taking a sip of water. Wet his whistle.
How do you think the dog feels?
Now he's, the trophies are coming out.
Here
Mr. Bradley is getting ready to award
Best in Show. I want to thank the breeders of these great dogs. I want to thank the owners, the handlers, and especially their assistants who have these dogs all in such perfect condition tonight. Best in Show at the 141st Annual Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show, the German Shepherd Dog.
Rumor wins Best in Show.
Rumor has it.
Rumor wins Best in Show. This is the second dog from the herding group to win Best in Show. The first one was in 1987, was a German Shepherd. And now Rumor in 2017 is the Best in Show winner of the Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show.
Made his mark, stood his ground.
Her mark,
excuse me, Rumor. 30 years and the herding group only the second time, as you mentioned, overcoming great odds, one of the more recent groups established. But victory to Rumor, and Karen is with the winner.
Thank you so much. Well, congratulations, Kent, to you and Rumor. Last year you were favored to win, and this is your year. How good does this feel?
Oh, it's like unbelievable. I gotta wind up maybe not saying a lot, just keep it together.
Okay, great. Sir, what was it about Rumor that sealed the deal for you tonight?
Well, you know, the German Shepherd Standard talks about quality and nobility, sometimes unrecognizable, but when you recognize it, it hits you home, and that's what it really is. She is just magnificent.
She absolutely is. Well, what is next for Rumor after going home Best in Show this year?
Well, she's going to be relaxing for a while, and we'll kind of find an appropriate husband for her, and hopefully there'll be some puppies in the future.
Okay, well, it is Valentine's Day. I do wish you the best of luck with that, Kent. Congratulations to you. Thank you, sir. Wonderful job, Chris. Back to you.
Thank you, Karen. 39th time a female has won Best in Show.